Okay, welcome back to Military Mayhem. We're going to do round 16. Now you might notice that the music is different, and also we have this thing here that looks like an enemy base. So I'm thinking this might be the last mission of the game. In this mission, things are set up a little bit differently. Enemy has a whole bunch of these Atlas cannons, so they're in a very strong defensive position. They have a little bit of anti-air, but not that much, and they have one hunter right there. In this base, they've got a Charlie that's gonna walk out and try to take this spot. And notice this spot has an eagle and a hunter, which is sort of a hint that we can probably take this. We're gonna find out. This one, however, has three hunters. Definitely an indication we're probably not gonna be able to take that. And indeed, we have no pelicans here. We got a Kilroy. He can walk down here and get this spot, which has an eagle. That's meant for us. Okay, so what are we gonna do? Well, rather than try to have our troops run headfirst into these defensive position, I'm going to try something else, which is to shift our units to the right. And then here, we've got a motorcycle, and we're going to bring our motorcycle out, and we're going to try to get our motorcycle into a safe position to take that back. A couple test tries to see if it was possible, and I think it is, but it's not easy. So we're gonna see that in action here. Let's see, what do I want to take out? We have this Hawkeye. Bring the Hawkeye out. With this Atlas. Look at the links up here. Now this Atlas cannon, we can't easily see for ourselves the distance it can reach, but I happen to know that right about here is safe. So I'm gonna move this tank over here. Additionally, right here between these two rocks is also safe. So let's see. Now, one of the places that isn't safe is right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, I made that mistake before, and I put the unit right there. So I'm gonna not do that this time. I'm gonna move this rabbit here. Not quite go here, so instead I'm going to position it one space down, I think, right here. That should be fine. A tank over, let me see, where do we want to put this? Well, we have this big boy, this giant, so we're going to move that down. Similarly, just trying to shift all of our units. I'm gonna say maybe throw one here. I think I can probably put it here. Would be okay. I also want to eye that, this Hadrian. Where do I want the Hadrian? I'm gonna put it, like, down here, I think. Have this tank maybe take the forward position in front of the Hadrian. Have the anti-air gun about here. This so this slagger can definitely come down and maybe attack our seeker. That's possible. But I'm thinking by abandoning this choke point, I'm gonna draw in maybe one or two units away from those Atlas cannons. We'll have a little bit of a better engagement here. And this hunter can really come cause havoc in many different possible ways. So I don't know where that is going to end up. Slagger coming down and attacking our Gilroy is a little dangerous. If the hunter comes and finishes the job, then we'll be in a lot of trouble. So it's not going for our Kilroy, that's good. Okay, now this has turned out, I think, pretty good. Now the Kilroy, you know, cannot reach there directly, but can move two spaces. That's fine. Our Hadrian can go ahead and get off a free shot on the slagger. Let's try to get this thing out of our business. Not very good. Now, this hunter is interfering with my plan. So we're gonna have to do something about that. But what exactly am I going to do? Let's see. Let's maybe have the bison try to kill this. So my immediate thought is to send this unit, maybe up here, also shift the Lynx to go attack it. Hawkeye, actually the Hawkeye can move here, providing maybe some zone of control. Ideally, I want to move here, I think. I don't know if it's possible for me to get there, but... Alright, we're gonna move this Hawkeye up. And then I'm gonna move this Rabbit up. Not a very strong attack. That is, in fact, really bad. Really was hoping not to lose that unit. Maybe should have had the Falcons attack first. Alright. My bison is now free to come up here. My motorcycle can get to about here, which is, you might notice, a little bit closer than here. Because I got to use the road. It turns out that is key. Rabbit can come up here, and again, what these units are trying to do is provide a safe zone of control, and so they don't have a lot of anti-air. Mostly they just have the Seeker, and they have this Rabbit, and so I'm going to try to provide cover for this piece of terrain right here. That's my goal, and I'm going to do that by moving. A lot of risks here. We've lost one unit, but I'm hoping that by doing it this way, we're going to take that factory. Of course, the risk here is this Atlas does get a free shot, but I'm hoping that that's the only shot they're going to get. Not have enough movement to go finish off my panther. So here we go. Feeling pretty good about this. Probably sacrificing a falcon to get this job done. Might survive, but might not. Yeah, gonna survive just barely. Now that is going to allow my falcon to escape, and I think successfully provide cover that I need. So, it worked, and their Kilroy is not even close, so they're not going to just be able to take it right back. That is another thing, like, this Charlie, like, the Charlie could have walked right to about here and would have been able to take it, but because of my military power in the area, they decided not to. Works in my favor. So one thing I can do is I can drop a mine, which would be kind of interesting. I'm kind of tempted to do that, just like drop a mine and see what happens, except for I think I can only take out 2 units a turn. And dropping a mine would mean I can't take out 2 units a turn. So that would be a problem. So both the Eagle and the Hunter are here. The Hunter stronger than the Eagle by a pretty good amount. That additional armor and everything. So I'll go ahead and put the Hunter here, I think. Of course, the Falcon, we're going to retreat. It has done its job. Probably don't want to put out any land units here, because we're still in range of that Atlas. And even these units, we probably want to have them retreat or something. So I'm just going to come in here to attack the Seeker, try to soften it up a little. that it leaves my arrogance alone. And then I think we're gonna try to just hightail it out. Same thing here, Bison. I think we just want to run away. Blinks, we can get a free attack. And I should try to get to safety. Let me see. Over here is actually safe. So now that this falcon has done its job, I should move this falcon over to the left side of the map, I think. Where's the Kilroy? Let's take this factory. Let's start unloading some very scary areas. Let me see. Oh, we have our giant. Usually our giant is so slow that we haven't been able to use it very much. See if we can kill the Seeker. Getting rid of their air defense is pretty high up on our list of priorities. Now, I think we are going to want to maybe get a Hawkeye out relatively soon. Maybe it doesn't have to come out this turn. Instead, let's get... Yeah, let's get the boulder out, I think. And I'm gonna get a Seeker out in this other location. We have a Seeker here. I mean, I could try to kill that. I guess there's no reason not to. Okay, so we have a Hawkeye. This Hawkeye probably wants to start moving in a westward direction. Okay, so measuring here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here is safe. Move here and not unload that gun. One of the things I want to do is I want to see if I can get maybe my Hunter and my Eagle to take out this Atlas. If we can do that, then I can drop this Atlas somewhere close to this base. It doesn't have to be right on the front lines, but somewhere around here. And that would pretty much be good enough, I think, to just set up our defense there. Here. I think we're done. Oh, we have one falcon remaining. Now, I don't think I need the falcon for any particular purpose. If I move it over here, they're gonna have multiple hunters. I'm just gonna move it all the way down here. It can't really do anything there, but that's fine. I just don't want it to get weakened by this Seeker just before they're going to pull out like the Rebreakers. But I'm feeling pretty good about this. You know, even with, you know, taking some pretty powerful hits to some of our good units, the unit count is probably not going to change at this point. Nobody's going to take Packery. So it's going to be 27 to 26. Most of their units, or rather not most, but many of their units are artillery that aren't going to move. As long as we don't advance, then I think we pretty much have this. What we have to do is not advance into the artillery. So that Charlie getting a little closer is a little bit scary. Definitely something for us to keep an eye on. We don't want it to take the factory back. Not right after I just said there's gonna be no exchange of factories anymore. So there's this anti-air gun. We're going to shift this up. See if we can take it out. I'm just poke and prod at it. That is definitely moving around the wrong way. I think the Eagle... I guess Eagle is about the same strength. It's a bit weaker. Alright, let's move this here. And attack the Charlie. Just want to keep this Charlie away from my base while I can do that. We're gonna go all the way around here and take out the Charlie. That should be good enough. Okay. Let's see. Giant attack the Titan. I can also just try to kill that Seeker, but as long as the Seeker is way over there, I guess I don't care that much about it. Have an eagle. Do you kind of want to bring the eagle in to attack stuff? But I do have to be careful. So let's stay close for now. Just try to take out the things that are right in front of me. Shift my bison in here to heal. Send my seeker out to protect. Want to protect that a little bit, so I'm gonna put my falcon here to kind of guard the zone control here, keep my eagle behind it. I think that Hadrian has a shot on my giant. Could be better. Let's see if we can empty this out. Yeah, let's get another hawk eye. So I have the panther, I mean, but is there any reason to play the panther? I don't think so. I think I'm gonna play a trigger. I know it's, like, kind of weird. But I think I just put the trigger out just to, annoy the enemy a little bit. Remove the Lennet. But I think this is good. Six spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. So, oh, right. That's why I'm not moving here. It's this Hadrian. But, okay. That bison's just gonna wait. That mule is just going to wait. We're gonna end. Seeker is just gonna go into the corner. That's fine. We'll take a shot from the Hadrian. Man, those giants just so much armor. Yeah, so I played the trigger mostly just to be in the way. And they're definitely in the way. They have tons of artillery, so I don't know if it really matters. They're, like, it's defending pretty well. 999 defense, wow. So I think that Charlie cannot reach the factory, so that's good. I'm pretty surprised about this game. I enjoy it a lot. Like, it's kind of a hidden gem of TurboGrafx-16. You know, I played a decent amount of TurboGrafx-16 games. Most of them, not really my thing. A couple of them, you know, the real bestsellers, like, some of those I like. But this one, I haven't really heard of. Gonna load the Charlie up in a Pelican, or at least they're not gonna do it this turn. Wait, you can load a giant in the Pelican? I could have sworn I've tried to do that and it said that like unit's too large or something. Okay. I am surprised. Kill this Charlie. I cannot suffer this guy to live. There we go. Alright, so the Falcon is going to have to come down here. We're gonna have the Falcon fight the Hunter. A little bit precarious here. We do have a Hunter of our own. Let's finish this Hunter off. Fail to. Let me see. Let's see if we can take this Hunter out. It's worth losing some Seekers to take them out. If I can get air dominance, then we are pretty much golden. Okay, that's pretty good. Not perfect, but it'll do. Here, but there's so many siege units in the way that that's just not going to do any good. Okay. here. Yeah, I'm gonna move this up. It's like, yeah, they have atlases, but at this point, they don't have enough atlases to, you know, pack this Hawkeye for free. Okay, and with my spare eagle, can do a lot. I mean, it can attack, which is nice. But I think what I'm going to do is actually, like, place it here. No, place it, here. And start hitting this Atlas. There we go. That's going to start breaking their defense. We can technically, you know, pull out, like, a Kilroy and stuff. Not a lot of reason to do it, but there's not a lot of reason not to. Let's have our Falcon come out. I don't know if I forgot that it was in there. Might have forgotten it was in there. That guy is dangerous. And the hunter's a little bit scary, but I mean, versus a full strength eagle, the weakened hunter's not gonna be enough. Same thing with this one. I might get a couple shots off, but that's gonna be it. Giant is the thing that's a little bit more scary, because its air attack is pretty substantial. Nah, we don't need those Seekers really anymore, so that's fine. With the death of the, two hunters here. Oh, they're even going for the Hawkeye. The Hawkeye is gonna have no purpose at all in, like, so I'm okay with that. The only downside of putting the trigger here is their units do get some experience points off of attacking it. But I think it served the purpose, which was just to gum up the works up there. Trigger. I wonder why it's called a trigger. It probably should be called, like, a trap. It must be a translation issue. Alright, so they're bringing out a couple more units. They still do have, actually, a hunter in there. So, might be speaking a little bit soon when I say I don't care about those anti-air, but think we're gonna be good. Alright, this falcon... It's time for that to retreat. This falcon can come out. Or connect with octopus. Interesting. I don't know. I guess the Atlas. The Atlas is more. It has like such a high range. Tempted to throw this eagle like just back inside so it can heal. And then I've got a hunter that I can just start sending around causing mayhem. So let's do that. Take care of this Hadrian. My Lynx come up here and attack, because I think this is a lot safer now without the Atlas in there. Gonna move around this thing. probably take a little bit of extra damage here than I have to. That's fine. So I could set my Panther over there, but I don't think there's any point in doing that, because I already have a unit over there that can conquer. Alright, my Falcon's healing, and I think that's good. I don't want to empty out that factory yet. Watch out for that Charlie for sure. That eagle has to get away. And there's the fruit shop for the Hadrian. Not too bad. I'm bicycling today. Ooh, got the one counterattack. Better. Grab it despite being in a weakened state. You know, it can attack air units, so it's something I wanted to get rid of. Titan came in and didn't attack anything. Huh. Their Falcon moved into melee range? Yeah, so that's gonna drop this giant over here. And giant does have some anti-air, so I'm gonna have to probably be careful of that. They pull their last hunter out. Okay. Yeah, interesting that they dropped the hunter over here. Okay, this eagle. Well, I kind of wanted the heal. I'm gonna send it in here. Now, we can deploy another eagle, so let's do that. A lot of possibilities here. Maybe I'll go for the Hadrian. Let's see how a surround works. Pistons are kind of weaker, but I guess with the surround, we still have enough to do the damage we need to do. Want to hit that octopus pretty badly, so that's what I'm gonna do. Adrian, let's see if we can kill it. There we go. Can't forget this guy's over here. let's make sure that we do not leave him alone. Otherwise, I think we're in a good position. Falcon doesn't have a lot of targets, we might as well just hit this pelican. Hunter, come back here, try to finish the Adrenal. Okay. Have our own Falcon. Take a free shot on the giant. Might as well. Total miss. I think the giant can't move onto that terrain. So I might be more or less safe there. Let's pull the eagle out. I know it's a little dangerous to put it right next to the giant, but I think I have an advantage. Evenly matched, I guess. Ooh. Here, though, they've been softened up. Alright, that Eagle's gonna have to go hide. It did what it needed to do. That's what I'm worried about, this full strength hunter. I yes, now I'm within range of this atlas. Yeah. That I forgot about. Have not checked the range on that one. So moving the rabbit in was a little bit premature. Friday night. Hanging out with some strategy games. Probably go out later. See you, Charlie. You can't hide. Titan, Octopus Titan. Let's hit the 3 health Titan. I might be able to kill this one. Pretty close. I guess we'll have the boulder try to finish it off. Having the giant fight the octopus is not, like, it's not amazing, but it's nice if I can, at least, giant is so slow, but I don't want to be in a position where, if I somehow fail to kill that, it just wouldn't have a spot to move to. We're gonna send this bison out here. I don't want that thing to get any closer. Okay, it may have a strength 1 falcon out here. It turns out we have a strength 8 falcon. And I think that's their last area on the field. My eagle's gonna go hide. Alright, what to bring out next? Oh, how about another eagle? That sounds good. I like my falcon where it is. Titan or a giant. I can also hit this giant, actually. Let's try to weaken this one. Because it's bothering my arrogance. It's gonna take, like, many hits to take it down. But it'll be worth it. Thank you. close. Of course, they still have this Atlas. Yeah, still not safe to take out any units here. Girl, we're gonna have to wait. Feeling pretty good about that. I think there's nothing else I can do here. So, center. Okay. It's going to attack my mule. It's an odd choice. Okay. Get out of here, Charlie. Get away from my face. Okay, so my Atlas cannon probably useless at this point. Start besieging some of these stationary defenses. Let's see. Giant. Yeah, I think I have the eagle. Try to finish this giant off. Not gonna go down without a fight. That grizzly is now on fire. Let's not advance any further there. This mule cannot even advance. Alright, whatever. Just get inside. This falcon can just get inside. That's fine. Send my polar down to heal. Hawkeye. Same. Not really much reason to do anything different. I'm gonna send my giant to go try to protect this unit over here. Grizzly's a little bit at risk. That's okay. Full power Atlas back there. Oof. I lose the Grizzly. Almost sure to lose it now. They've got some seekers guarding their artillery. But I don't think that's gonna work for very long. We have enough air units. They just don't have the mobility to take care of us. Would be if this Charlie could make a tour base, but other than that, it doesn't matter if I'm with him. There we go. Falcons, but I'm thinking maybe just bringing out the Lynx. Seeker is a bit strong. It still has full health. And we can't really advance it else. Now, one of the things I'm noticing is that we're not getting any special music for having more than twice as many units as the enemy. assuming that's a because this is this special mission. We get some special music, but we also don't get victory music. So just these two seekers really left? Motorcycle. Yeah, maybe I can take that factory, why not? Strong enough to take out this giant? Maybe. Maybe I just want to bring it in and hit this slagger. Ooh, wow. Straight at full health. I guess because I... Did I have a full surround or almost a full surround on that? I guess I... wasn't paying that close attention to the calculation. So the Atlas can hit all the way over there. Yeah. It's gonna happen. Okay, so the Seeker is running away. I really don't want it to engage my units. no possibility of taking damage would be great. So they've got two Seekers, two Atlases, and that's it. Given that, probably not going to move up most of my units, because they're not going to get here in time. Oh, that's rough terrain. Bad motorcycle, can't do anything here. Get back in there. Bring out one more air unit. Why not? And I think that's it. It's just gonna be about air units at this point. The stuff I'm doing with my bisons here is mostly just for speed purposes. Just to make sure that this doesn't go forever. My air units can take out all these defenses, but I have enough spare ground units, might as well send them. Just these two units left, huh? Alright, let's adjust the cannons. Alright, just one more cannon left. Not a bad mission. Tackling this took me a few tries, just to make sure I could get that factory that was on the right side. But once I had that, it felt pretty easy. The Allied forces have just disarmed the devastating Sam, and the leaders of the Axis are... destruction. On May 18th, 2089, the Battle of the Moon ended with a sensational triumph. For the Allied powers, under your courageous command, the prisoners were freed from their camps and the forces were organized. Allied army was able to disarm the deadly Sam before it could be launched. On May 24th, the Axis Empire signed a treaty for their unconditional surrender in the Allied World Nation headquarters. The whole world has recognized your outstanding heroics. They owe their lives and freedoms to you. Your strategic superiority has put an early end to the evil Axis Empire's military madness. Congratulations, name drop of the game. For some reason, stars are now visible from the moon. Ooh, like pseudo 3D. I guess. And now, let's go to another planet, maybe. Like that was a satisfying ending. It reminded me a bit of my feeling when I did beat Advance Wars as well. Like with Advance Wars, like I guess that had the problem that they introduced units all the way up until the final chapter, so you didn't really ever have an opportunity to play with all the units except for like one or two missions. This sort of had the opposite problem, where they introduced almost all the units right away, and then they went back and had some more interesting missions where there's, you know, different distribution of units and so forth. But I still sort of feel after 16 missions that there wasn't a lot of variety. Not a lot of variety to the missions. Towards the end, it definitely got tough. Mission 15 and Mission 16, I did have to restart a few times, just because, like, you know, if you don't have a first good, like, second or third turn to get that factory, then there's just nothing you can do. You're playing from behind, often a huge deficit. There could be a swing of difference of, like, you getting plus 10 versus them getting plus 10 units. It's like 20-unit swing. So at that point, it's worth just resetting and trying again. It'll take a lot less time to do that. I can see, that they did make some improvements when they did Advance Wars. One of the things that a little bit odd about this game is that the units that you have, they're already pre-built. Like, you don't have any money. Instead, you capture these neutral camps that have a certain amount of resources already within them. And it's really just a matter of who can get there first, if you can get there in the first three turns or not. And whoever gets there in the first three turns, you basically just get everything. Once the units are out, the camp is mostly pointless. So there's a lot of problems from a design standpoint, right? Like, it's enough interest for 16 missions or so, but you're gonna quickly run out of designs that work or do interesting things because of the lack of, you know, currency, the lack of ability to build new units. you could maybe make a mission where there's a neutral base that's 4 or 5 turns away from your current start. The problem there, right, is like the whole mission only takes usually 10 turns. So if it takes you 5 turns to get to camp, it'll probably take you 5 turns to get back. At which point, you know, getting the camp at all doesn't help you. Like, you could probably just win the mission first. Which seems to be why all the camps are between 2 and 3 turns away at most from your starting location. If it was any different, they just, yeah, wouldn't play any role. And they, if they're anything more than, like, one turn, if they're anything less than 2 turns away, then you just take them on your first turn. Like, it doesn't really make a difference except for one single unit is unable to advance. Like, you have one infantry take a camp on the first turn instead of walking towards the camp. In that way, I can see why they changed a lot of things as this went on. As I understand, like, Military Madness is the first game in the series. There's a number of other games, like Nectaris, I believe, is... I don't know if that's the same game, just renamed, or slightly different game in the same series, but there's also, you know, Game Boy Wars and Advance Wars, which all play very similarly. Advance Wars adds in commanders, and it adds in ocean units, which are not here. It does simplify a few things, right? Like, you're no longer using a hex grid, you're now using a square grid. But almost, and you know, you'll lose a few units. Like, the trigger, it appeared in a couple missions, but it never really felt like it did anything. Like, at all. Other than just sitting there on the map. Like, I tried to make it do something interesting on this map by having it block some unit movement, but actually I had enough other units that were giving zone of control that it wasn't necessary. Mostly all it did was give experience points to my enemy artillery units. So, anyway. That's my thoughts about this game. I enjoyed playing it. Probably would not play it any more than I have already. But it does, you know, it did make me aware that in addition to Advance Wars, there's a few versions of this, you know, for like Super Nintendo. And that made me kind of interested. I might check those out, see how they compare and contrast, see what they learned over, you know, the 5 or so years between this game and the Super Nintendo version. This came out in the 89. SNES, probably most of the games around like 93. So maybe a 93 version. Might be a little bit more streamlined, a little bit more improved in certain ways. I'm kind of interested to see what they kept and what they got rid of there. Anyway, that's all I've got. Thanks for watching.